Hello, everyone. Welcome to Revive Church San Antonio. We are so excited that you are joining us tonight for service. Make sure that you say hello in the comments. My name is Shreya, and I'm excited to worship with you on tonight. Tonight, we have a powerful series. We're continuing Undefeated. If you have been a part of this Undefeated process in this series, we ask you to put some likes. Share this, and let us know that you've been blessed by putting likes in the comments, sharing this message with your friends, and letting them know it's a series that they don't want to miss. And if they've missed a few services, they can always go back and listen on YouTube. If this is your first time and you are a guest with us tonight, would you please put some hearts in the comments below so that we can love on you and we can welcome you to Revive. We have an amazing online team that is ready to greet you. And all of those that are part of the online family, put some sunshines in the comments. Let me know that you're watching. Let me know that you are ready to worship with me. If you know me, you know worship is my favorite part of service. So I'm ready to worship. I want to see who's online and who's a part of the family that's worshiping with us tonight. Let's check it out. Hi, Addie. Thank you for watching. We miss you. Hi, Pastor Kyle and Tamara. Thank you for watching. I see Marcos. Thank you for joining us. This is all of our online family. They're worshiping while they're on vacation, and we hope that you are doing the same. Make sure that you share this and you let your friends and your family know that they don't want to miss this message on tonight. Pastor Humberto has something amazing in store for you. He is here to encourage you and to empower you that you are undefeated because God is, and he is living right in you. We have a few announcements that I want to share with you all this evening, and one of those is Baptism Sunday is going to be May the 2nd. If you want to be baptized and you want to be take the next steps to be in the body of Christ, we want you to register online. All you have to do is go to our website, revivechurchsa.com, and select the Connections tab. There, you're able to register for baptisms, and you're able to register for any events that we have. So our next one is the baptisms, May the 2nd. And it will be at our 6 p.m. service. Make sure that you register. And after you register, let us know in the comments that you're going to be a part of baptisms because we want to celebrate with you on May the 2nd. Our next announcement is May the 1st is Youth Night. So if you have any youth and you want them to be a part of Revive Youth, please make sure that you register online at revivechurchsa.com. www.revivechurchsa.com. There you're able to register your youth for Youth Night, which is going to be May the 1st. And you'll get all the details once you register, so be sure that you do register. Youth Night is one of our newest ministries, and they are booming. Our youth are having a great time in the Lord. This past week, they were able to meet with our pastors on Zoom. And what I hear is May the 1st is going to be an in-person Youth Night, so you don't want to miss that one. So I'm encouraging all of our parents to be sure to register. If you have not already downloaded our app, make sure you grab your phone and you download the app because it is an amazing app. There, not only are you able to catch up on the current events, you're also linked to our YouTube channel where you can see all of the messages that Pastor Humberto has preached for the year 2021. And there are some from 2020 that are up on our YouTube channel. So there you can catch up. But one of my favorite parts of the app is the prayers, the prayer community. So there, if you have any prayer requests, all you have to do is get on the app, put on your prayer request, and someone's praying for you. And the beauty of it is you'll know when they're praying for you because you'll get a notification that someone has prayed and touched and agreed on your request. So if that's for you, make sure that you download this app and be blessed by it. Let me see who all is watching and who's ready to worship. If you're ready for worship this evening, if you're ready to give God a thunderous praise, I would like for you to put in the comments the dancing emoji and let me know that you're ready to dance with me. You're ready to give God the glory because he has done great things. Not only has he done great things, he's undefeated. So we are victorious. So that's all we have to dance about. If nothing else, we can dance that he is victorious. He is undefeated. Let me check and see who's watching with me. Hello, hello, everyone. I thank you guys for watching. And go ahead and make sure that you share this. Make sure that you tag a friend, you tag a family member that you think needs to be encouraged. Another announcement that we have is May the 9th. May the 9th is Mother's Day. Is Bring Your Mama to Church Sunday. So make sure that May the 9th, you mark your calendars, you tell your mom now, get her Sunday best, her Sunday outfit ready, that we have service at 6 p.m. and we want your mom in the building. Our pastors have a word to touch their lives. Make sure that you mark your calendars and don't forget, May the 9th, bring your mama to church. See who else is here. Hey, Jacob. Thank you, Jacob, for watching. Be sure that you share, you share, you share. We thank all of our online family for joining us and staying connected, even though you are virtual, even though you're from a distance. We love you. We appreciate your support and your commitment to continuing to serve here at Revive Church in the community. We honor you all. Hey, Addie, I'm ready to dance with you, girl. I'm ready to worship. Make sure that you take some pictures of the worship that's happening in your home and tag the church so that we all are worshiping together as a community. We thank you. You guys start getting your things together. Start preparing your hearts and your minds for service. We're about to start. Make sure that you share this. Make sure you call a friend that needs to hear that God is undefeated, that needs just a little bit of encouragement this week. This message is going to bless you. I guarantee you, there's something in my spirit telling me that we are going to walk out empowered for this week. God has so much in store for us this week. And this message is going to get you through. Now, what we want you to do is gather your things, gather your families, get together in front of the TV, and let's get ready to worship.
many of you believe that we're fighting a God, or serving a God who fights our battles tonight? The Bible says in Exodus chapter 14 that He will fight our battles. We only need to be still. And I don't know what you came in here carrying today, but the safest place to lay your confidence is in His promises. How many of you can hold on to that today? Let's just begin to worship Him. God, we exalt You. You are faithful. You are worthy of all the glory, of all the honor, of all the praise. We exalt You, God.
Come on, church, lift up your hands there where you are.
Vamos, iglesia, levante sus manos ahí donde están.
The presence of God is in this room.
La presencia de Dios está en este lugar.
And I know that we are confident.
Y yo sé que estamos confiados.
That as the presence of God is moving.
Que mientras la presencia de Dios se mueve.
His presence is in this place.
Su presencia está en este lugar.
And if you're here in this room.
Y si tú estás aquí en este lugar.
And you need God to touch your heart.
Y necesitas que Dios toque tu corazón.
You're in the right place.
Estás en el lugar correcto.
At the right time.
En el momento correcto.
With the right people.
Con la gente correcta.
Everyone with their hands up.
Todos con sus manos levantadas.
Everyone with their hands up.
Todos con sus manos levantadas.
Father, we pray, Lord.
Padre, oramos.
Presence.
Que tu presencia.
And your move.
Y tu movimiento.
Of your spirit.
De tu espíritu.
Begin to move in this room.
Comiencen a moverse en este
Begin
lugar.
To dwell in this room.
Comiencen a estar en este lugar.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
We honor you, Holy Spirit.
Te honramos, Espíritu Santo.
And we declare Holy Spirit
y
to
declaramos
come.
El Espíritu Santo que venga.
And every other spirit has to go.
Y cualquier otro espíritu se tiene
come
que
on,
ir.
Say this with me. Holy Spirit,
vamos,
come.
Díganlo conmigo, Espíritu Santo.
Holy Spirit, come.
Espíritu Santo, ven.
Holy Spirit, come.
Espíritu Santo, ven.
Holy Spirit, come.
Espíritu Santo,
when
ven.
You invite the Holy Spirit,
invitamos al Espíritu Santo.
Everything that is not of God has to go.
Y todo lo que no es de Dios se tiene que ir.
Every fear,
todo temor,
depression,
la depresión,
anxiety,
la ansiedad,
it all has to go.
Todo se tiene que ir.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Come on, invite the Holy Spirit there where
vamos,
you are.
Vamos, invita al Espíritu
Come on,
Santo ahí donde
estás.
Invita al Espíritu Santo ahí donde estás.
With every hand lifted high.
Con toda mano
with
levantada.
Every hand lifted high.
Toda mano levantada.
With every hand lifted high.
Toda
Holy
mano
Spirit,
levantada. Espíritu Santo.
We thank you, Holy Spirit,
Espíritu Santo.
For what's already been done.
Gracias por lo que
we
ya
thank
fue
you,
hecho.
Holy Spirit,
te damos gracias, Espíritu Santo. Por lo que ya fue hecho.
For the victory that is already ours.
Por la victoria que ya es de nosotros.
And we thank you.
Y te damos gracias.
For your presence.
Por tu presencia.
Come on, let's begin to put our hands together tonight.
Vamos, pongan sus manos
together,
juntas.
Put your hands together. Give
pongan
him praise.
Sus manos juntas.
Give him honor.
Dale honor.
Give him glory.
Dale gloria.
Because he is mighty.
Porque él es victorioso.
Turn to your neighbor and just tell him it's so good to see you tonight.
Dile a tu vecino es un gozo de
it's
verte.
It's so good to see you tonight.
Es tan bueno verte en esta noche.
We are the lead pastors of Revive Church.
Somos los pastores de Iglesia Revive.
And our vision is simple.
Y la visión es simple.
We are leading people.
Estamos guiando a la gente.
To encounter God.
Que se encuentre con Dios.
His presence.
Su presencia.
And his power.
Y su poder.
Our vision.
Nuestra visión.
Is to lead people.
Es guiar a la gente.
To encounter God.
A encontrarse con Dios.
His presence.
Su presencia.
And his power.
Y su poder.
Look at your neighbor and tell them I'm excited to see you.
Dile a tu vecino estoy contento de verte.
And I'm excited to praise God with you.
Estoy contento de alabar contigo.
Thank you, band.
Gracias, banda.
You can stay here, Jacob, for a little bit. Let's open up our Bibles here tonight.
Vamos a abrir nuestras Biblias.
If you got your Bibles, open it up.
Abran sus Biblias.
I believe the Lord is going to speak to us.
Yo sé que Dios nos va a hablar en esta noche.
Isn't God good?
Que no, Dios es bueno.
Is the Lord good?
Dios es bueno.
Someone shout all the time.
Todos griten todo el tiempo.
There's no day that he's not good.
No hay un día que no es bueno.
Matthew chapter 28.
Mateo capítulo 28.
Verse 18.
Versículo 18.
Matthew chapter 28.
Mateo 28.
And verse 18.
18.
When you got it, say I got it.
Cuando lo tengan, digan lo tengo.
And if you don't got it, say hold up.
Si no lo tienen, digan un momento.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Matthew 28:18.
Mateo 28:18.
And Jesus came and he spoke to them, saying, "All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth."
Jesús se acercó y les habló diciendo, toda potestad me es dada en el cielo y en la tierra.
All authority
toda potestad
has been given to me.
Me es dada en el cielo y en la tierra.
In heaven
en el cielo
and on earth.
Y en la tierra.
Verse 19.
Versículo 19.
Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Por tanto, id y haced discípulos a todas las naciones, bautizándolos en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo.
I believe that authority is something that Jesus has.
Yo creo que la autoridad es algo que Dios tiene.
And Jesus said, not only will I have authority in the heavens.
Y Jesús dijo, no solamente tengo autoridad en los cielos,
but I have authority on the earth.
Pero tengo autoridad sobre la tierra.
And there's another version that says, and under the earth.
Y hay otra versión que dice, y debajo de la tierra.
Jesus says, that authority has been given to me.
Jesús dice, esa autoridad se me fue dada.
Let's jump to Ephesians chapter 1.
Vamos a Efesios capítulo 1.
Ephesians chapter 1.
Efesios capítulo 1.
And verse 20.
Versículo 20.
Which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated Christ or seated him at the right hand in heavenly places.
Esta fuerza operó en Cristo, resucitándolo de los muertos y sentándolo a su derecha en los lugares celestiales.
Where was Jesus seated?
¿Dónde estaba sentado Jesús?
Everyone shout in heavenly places.
Todos griten en lugares celestiales.
Now because he's in heavenly places, verse 21.
Versículo 21.
Far above every principality and power and might or authority and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this age but also that which is to come.
Sobre todo principado y autoridad, poder y señorío, y sobre todo nombre que se nombra, no solo en este siglo sino también en el venidero.
Far above all rule and all authority,
sobre todo principado y autoridad,
and power and dominion,
poder y señorío,
and above every name that is named,
y sobre todo nombre que se nombra,
not only in this age,
no solo en este siglo,
but also the one to come,
sino también en el venidero.
For the next few minutes tonight,
por los próximos minutos en esta noche,
I want to speak to you,
quiero hablarles sobre parte 2
of undefeated,
de ser invencible.
And tonight I want to speak to you about undefeated authority.
Y en esta noche quiero hablar sobre la autoridad invencible.
Someone shout undefeated authority.
Alguien grite autoridad invencible.
Father, we thank you for your presence.
Padre, te damos gracias por tu presencia en este lugar.
We honor you.
Te honramos. Gracias.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
And everyone shout amen.
Y todos griten amén.
And amen.
Y amén.
You may be seated tonight.
Pueden tomar su lugar en esta noche.
Thank you. All authority in heaven.
Toda autoridad en los cielos y en la tierra.
Was given to Jesus Christ.
Se le fue dada a Jesucristo.
I want to allow us to understand this concept.
Y quiero permitirnos para entender este concepto.
Because it's important that all of us understand what authority means.
Porque es importante que todos nosotros entendamos qué es la autoridad.
Everywhere Jesus went,
donde quiera que Jesús fue,
he would heal the sick.
Él sanaba a los enfermos.
And they would ask him this question.
Y le hacían esta pregunta.
They would say, "In what authority do you cast out these demons?"
Le preguntaban, ¿con qué autoridad es que tú sacas estos demonios?
Or in what authority do you heal the sick?
¿O con qué autoridad es que tú sanas a los enfermos?
And it was a question of authority.
Y fue una pregunta de autoridad.
There was a man that came to Jesus one day.
Había un hombre que llegó a Jesús un día.
He was a centurion.
Él fue un centuriano.
He was un centurión.
Centurión.
And he was a chief.
Y él fue un jefe.
And he comes to Jesus.
Y él llega a Jesús.
And he says, "Jesus."
Y le dice, "Jesús."
My soldier or my servant is sick.
Mi soldado o mi sirviente está enfermo.
He's literally dying.
Él literalmente se está muriendo.
But I know that you are a man under authority.
Pero yo reconozco que tú eres un hombre bajo autoridad.
So because you're a man under authority,
entonces como tú eres un hombre bajo autoridad,
you don't have to even go.
Tú no tienes que ir.
You should just send the word.
Solamente tienes que mandar la palabra.
And there was something so powerful about this moment.
Y había algo tan poderoso con este momento.
That even Jesus.
Que hasta Jesús.
Looked at this man.
Miró a este hombre.
And watch this.
Miren esto.
Jesus says, "I have never met a man with this much faith."
Y él dijo, "Yo nunca he conocido un hombre con tanta fe."
It wasn't that the man had so much faith.
No es que el hombre tenía tanta fe.
It was the fact that he understood the protocol. In the kingdom.
Es que ese hombre entendió el protocolo del reino.
He had a revelation of a dimension that was beyond the supernatural.
Él tenía una revelación de una dimensión que fue más allá de lo natural.
And literally what he was trying to say,
y literalmente lo que él estaba tratando de decir,
was just as I tell my soldiers to go, they go.
Es que así como yo le digo a mis soldados que vayan, ellos van.
When I tell my servants to come, they come.
Cuando le digo a mis siervos que vengan, vienen.
And because you are a man under authority, just like I am.
Y como tú eres un hombre bajo autoridad, así como yo.
He says you don't even have to show up.
Él dijo, tú no ni tienes que aparecer.
Because your word is your servant.
Porque tu palabra es tu siervo.
I want you to catch this tonight.
Quiero que capturen esto en esta noche.
This man understood that the words of Jesus.
Este hombre entendió que las palabras de Jesús.
Were the servants of Jesus.
Fueron los siervos de Jesús.
He says all you got to do is send your word.
Él dijo, todo lo que tú tienes que hacer es mandar tu palabra.
Because when you send the word.
Porque cuando tú mandas la palabra.
The word will go and do what it was sent to do.
La palabra irá y hará lo que tiene que hacer.
The word will not return to me void.
La palabra no regresará tras vacía.
That's why when God sends a word.
Por eso cuando Dios manda una palabra.
His word must fulfill what it was sent to do.
Su palabra tiene que cumplir lo que fue enviado a hacer.
So each and every one of us that are in this room.
Entonces cada uno de nosotros que estamos en este lugar.
Must understand this concept of authority.
Tenemos que entender este concepto de autoridad.
Because when you understand authority.
Porque cuando tú entiendes la autoridad.
You understand that authority.
Tú entiendes que la autoridad
only comes when you're submitted.
Solamente viene cuando tú estás sometido.
Y'all didn't sound no amens in this room.
Ay, no había ningún amén allí.
I said authority only comes when you're submitted.
La autoridad solamente viene cuando tú estás sometido.
What does this mean, pastor?
¿Qué significa esto, pastor?
You are not authorized to use the name of Jesus.
Tú no tienes la autoridad para usar el nombre de Jesús.
Unless you're submitted to the name of Jesus.
Hasta que tú estés sometido bajo el nombre de Jesús.
Somebody say,
Alguien diga,
Say that was good.
Eso fue
now,
bueno.
Tell them that was for you because I'm submitted.
Dile a tu vecino, eso fue para ti porque yo estoy sometido.
Y'all don't remember when they came and these demons came and tormented these men?
¿Se acuerdan cuando llegaron algunos demonios y atormentaron a unos hombres?
There was some men that tried to cast out these demons.
Había algunos hombres que trataron de sacar un demonio.
And they said, we cast you out with the name that Peter preaches.
Y ellos dijeron, te sacamos en el nombre que predica Pedro.
We cast you out with in the name that John preaches.
Te sacamos en el nombre que Juan predica.
And the demons looked at these two men.
Y los demonios miraron a estos dos hombres.
And he said, y'all crazy.
Y le dijeron, tú estás loco.
Y'all dumb.
Están bien.
Because we know Peter.
Porque nosotros conocemos a Pedro.
We know John.
Nosotros conocemos a Juan.
We know the ones that followed the name.
Nosotros conocemos a los que siguen el nombre.
But we don't know you.
Pero no los conocemos a ustedes.
And the Bible says.
Y la Biblia dice.
That because they did not know the men.
Que porque no conocieron a los hombres.
The demons literally attacked these men.
Los demonios literalmente atacaron a estos hombres.
And left them butt naked.
Y los dejaron desnudos.
Read your Bible.
Lean su Biblia.
They literally stripped them away.
Literalmente les quitaron la ropa.
Beat them up.
Los pegaron.
The reason why.
Y la razón por qué.
Is because they said we know Peter because he submitted.
Nosotros conocemos a Pedro porque él está sometido.
We know John because he submitted.
Nosotros conocemos a Juan porque él está sometido.
But you're not authorized to use the name you're not submitted under.
Pero tú no tienes autoridad a usar el nombre en la cual tú no estás sometido.
Why do you and I carry authority?
Porque tú y yo cargamos autoridad.
Because we're submitted under the name that is above every name.
Porque nosotros estamos sometidos bajo el nombre que está sobre todo nombre.
The name we sing about.
El nombre en cual nosotros cantamos.
The name we shout about.
El nombre en cual nosotros gritamos.
The name that we seal every prayer with.
El nombre en cual nosotros sellamos toda oración.
It's the name above every name.
Es el nombre que está sobre todo nombre.
That's the name of Jesus.
Ese es el nombre de Jesús.
Can we just shout the name of Jesus here
¿Podemos
tonight?
Gritar el nombre de Jesús en esta noche?
Can somebody just throw up their hands and say Jesus?
¿Alguien puede levantar sus manos y decir Jesús?
Shout Jesus.
Griten Jesús.
It's the name, that name.
Es ese nombre
in which demons tremble.
En la cual los demonios tiemblan.
It's when you declare that name.
Es cuando tú declaras ese nombre.
With authority.
Con autoridad.
Every demon has to flee.
Todo demonio tiene que irse.
Every cancer has to dry up.
Todo cáncer se tiene que secar.
Every tumor has to dismantle.
Todo tumor se tiene que desaparecer.
When you declare the name.
Cuando tú declaras el nombre.
Why is the name so powerful,
pastor? ¿Por qué ese nombre es tan poderoso, pastor?
Because that name can do anything for you.
Porque ese nombre puede hacer cualquier cosa
that
por
name
ti.
Can move mountains. mountains.
Ese nombre puede mover montañas.
That name can heal a blind eye.
Ese nombre puede sanar los ojos ciegos.
That name can unlock a ear.
Ese nombre puede sanar las orejas, los oídos.
It's that name.
Es ese nombre.
When you declare it, depression has to go.
Cuando tú lo declaras, esa persona se tiene que sanar.
It's that name.
Ese nombre,
where suicidal thoughts have to flee.
Donde los pensamientos de suicidio tienen que irse.
It's that name.
Es ese nombre.
Haven't you ever been attacked in a dream?
¿Nunca has sido atacado en un sueño?
And you feel like your mouth is being shut.
¿Y sientes que tu boca se está haciendo cerrada?
And you feel darkness come over your body.
¿Y luego sientes esa oscuridad venir sobre ti?
And you're fighting in your dream.
¿Y estás peleando en tu sueño?
What are you fighting for?
¿Qué estás peleando?
You're trying to declare a name.
Estás tratando de declarar un nombre.
Because you know that if you can just get Jesus out
porque
of your
tú
mouth.
Sabes que cuando tratas de decir Jesús
whatever
de tu boca,
had a grip on you
cualquier cosa que tenía un aguante
has to release
en ti,
you because it understands a name.
Te tiene que soltar porque entiende a un nombre.
I wish I had a church here tonight that would shout the name.
Quisiera que tuviera una iglesia aquí que gritara ese nombre.
Shout the name over San Antonio.
Grita ese nombre sobre San Antonio.
Shout that name over your children.
Grita ese nombre sobre tus hijos.
Shout that name on your household.
Grita ese nombre en tu casa.
You gotta shout that name in your home.
Tienes que gritar ese nombre en tu casa.
You can't have a demon sleeping with you in the same bed when you got a name.
Tú no puedes tener un demonio durmiendo contigo cuando tú tienes un nombre.
Pastor, I get attacked in my sleep.
Ay, es pastor, es que yo me atacan en mis sueños.
Pastor, I can't sleep. I get tormenting dreams.
Yo no puedo dormir porque tengo sueños que me atormentan.
How are you tormented by a demon?
¿Cómo puedes ser atormentado por un demonio?
When you got the authority of the name to cast it out.
Cuando tú tienes la autoridad de un nombre que lo puedes sacar.
Somebody say, teach me, Pastor, teach me.
Alguien diga, Pastor, enséñame.
Well, you're not coming here so that we can give a massage to the demon you've been sleeping with.
No venís aquí para darle un masaje al demonio con la cual estás durmiendo.
We came here to teach you the authority that you have in Christ Jesus.
Venimos a enseñarte la autoridad en cual tú tienes en Cristo Jesús.
Because if his name is undefeated,
porque si su nombre es invencible,
and you carry the name with you,
y tú cargas ese nombre contigo,
you can actually walk an undefeated life.
Eso significa que tú puedes vivir una vida invencible.
Because you got the life of the name that you cried out at one point of your life and you cried out to that name for salvation.
Porque tú tienes la vida de ese nombre que algún día tú llamaste para la salvación.
You said, Jesus, I need you.
Y tú dijiste, Jesús, te necesito.
And Jesus came in you.
Y Jesús entró en ti.
Through his spirit.
A través de su espíritu.
And now where I go,
y ha sido a donde quiera que yo vaya,
is with me.
Su espíritu está conmigo.
When I pray,
cuando yo oro,
I pray in the name of Jesus.
Yo oro en el nombre de Jesús.
You want to know why?
¿Saben por qué?
Because demons don't know you.
Porque los demonios no conocen a ti.
But they know who you represent.
Pero ellos conocen a quien tú representas.
They may not know your name.
A lo mejor no conocen tu nombre.
But they sure do know his.
Pero conocen al de él.
They know when he walks into a room.
Él sabe cuando tú entras a un cuarto.
They know when you invite him his presence to a room.
Ellos saben cuando tú invitas su presencia a un lugar.
Y'all looking at me like y'all don't know y'all's Bible.
Ustedes me están mirando como si no saben su Biblia.
Someone say, teach me, Pastor.
Alguien diga, Pastor, enséñame.
Y'all remember when Jesus tells his disciples, let's go to the other side.
¿Se acuerdan cuando Jesús le dijo a sus discípulos, vayamos al otro lado?
And he says, men,
y le dijo, hombres,
we're crossing over.
Vamos a cruzar al otro lado.
We're going to the other side.
Vamos a cruzar al otro lado.
Jesus didn't tell him what he was going to do.
Jesús no les dijo lo que iba a hacer.
He just said, let's go to the other side.
Solamente dijo, vayamos al otro lado.
And isn't it crazy?
¿Y qué no es un poco loco?
That the word is released,
que en el momento cuando se soltó la palabra,
the attack came against the disciples.
El ataque vino sobre los discípulos.
Jesus says, we're going to the other side.
Jesús dijo, vayamos al otro lado.
And the enemy raises up a storm against them.
Y el enemigo levanta una tormenta en contra de ellos.
We might know the story.
A lo mejor nosotros sabemos la historia.
The Bible says that Jesus was sleeping on a pillow.
La Biblia dice que Jesús estaba durmiendo.
The storm came.
Y la tormenta vino.
And begins to hit the boat.
Y comienza a darle al barco.
And the disciples get fearful.
Y los discípulos empiezan a temorizar.
So much so.
Que tanto que
that they went and they woke up Jesus.
Que fueron a despertar a Jesús.
They said, Jesus,
y dijeron, Jesús,
wake up.
Despiértate.
How are you sleeping when we're in the middle of a storm?
¿Cómo puedes dormir cuando estamos en medio de una tormenta?
They didn't know that the word,
ellos no sabían que la palabra
had already been released.
Ya había sido suelta.
Even if a storm arose,
y aunque una tormenta se levantara,
even if the waves beat against the boat,
aunque las olas pegaban en contra del barco, ¿saben algo?
They were still gonna get to the other side.
Todavía ellos iban a llegar al otro lado.
That's why when a word is released over your life,
por eso cuando una palabra es suelta sobre tu vida,
isn't it crazy that the storm only comes after the word is released?
¿Que no es raro que la tormenta viene cuando después de la palabra fue suelta?
So watch this, y'all.
Entonces miren esto.
What if the attack isn't against you?
¿Qué pasa si el ataque no fue contra de ti?
What if it's against the word becoming fulfilled in you?
¿Qué pasa si es en contra de la palabra que así se quiere cumplir en tu vida?
But you get mad because your car don't start on a Sunday night.
Pero tú te enojas porque tu carro no prende en un domingo.
Some of y'all were fighting in the parking lot. I know this because I'm a prophet too. But some of y'all were fighting in the parking lot before you got in here.
Algunos estaban peleando aquí en el estacionamiento. Soy profeta, por eso yo sé antes de llegar aquí.
You were arguing before you walked into this room.
Estabas peleándote antes de entrar a este lugar.
And you don't know that the devil's not after your car.
Y tú no sabes que el diablo no está en contra, está viniendo por tu carro.
He's not even after your marriage.
Él ni viene por tu matrimonio.
He ain't after your husband.
Él no viene por tu esposo.
You don't want your husband. Why does he want him?
Tú no quieres a tu esposo porque lo quiere él.
Ah, got it. So I got to stick around with. Yeah, you got to stick around with them.
Sí, te tienes que quedar con esa persona.
You don't like your wife. Why is the devil gonna want her?
Si tú no quieres a tu esposa, ¿cómo lo va a querer el diablo?
So the attack isn't against you.
Entonces el ataque no es en contra de ti.
The attack is against the word that's released, getting inside of you.
El ataque está en contra de la palabra que fue suelta y ahora está dentro de ti.
That's why when we prophesy,
por eso cuando profetizamos,
and you release a word over someone,
y tú sueltas una palabra sobre alguien,
not only are you hearing that word,
no solamente estás escuchando esa palabra,
your enemy hears the word too.
Pero tu enemigo escucha esa palabra también.
So Jesus says, let's cross to the other side.
Entonces Jesús dice, crucemos al otro lado.
Watch this.
Miren esto.
The storm arises.
La tormenta se levanta.
They wake up Jesus.
Le despiertan a Jesús.
Jesus says, storm, shut up.
Y él dice, tormenta, cállate.
Literally, that's in book of 1 Humberto, chapter 2, verse 7.
Literalmente, esa está en el libro de Humberto.
Jesus says, storm, be silent.
Y él le dice, ten paz.
He shuts off the storm.
Se termina la tormenta.
The disciples look at him.
Y los discípulos lo ven.
Who is this man?
¿Quién es este hombre?
That he has the authority.
Que él tiene la autoridad.
To tell the wind to shut up.
Para decirle al viento que se calle.
Isn't it crazy that the disciples didn't even know the man they were hanging around with?
Que no es loco que los discípulos ni conocieron al hombre en cual ellos se juntaban
But
todos los días.
Jesus.
Pero mira a Jesús.
He looks at them.
Él los mira a ellos.
And he says, "Where is your faith?"
Y luego dice, "¿Dónde está tu fe?"
Because they had authority in the same boat with them.
Porque tenían autoridad en el mismo barco con él.
But they didn't have the faith to believe.
Pero no tenían la fe para creer.
That if Jesus said, "We're going to the other side."
Que si Jesús dijo que cruzaremos al otro lado.
Come hell or high water, we're getting to the other side.
Si vengan las aguas o si viene el infierno, vamos a ir al otro lado. Si él lo dijo,
and I dare to believe it,
y si yo me arriesgo a creerlo,
then it has to be done.
Entonces tiene que suceder.
I wish I had some people that could just rip the word out of heaven.
Quisiera que tener a gente aquí que solamente arrancar esa palabra.
And say, if he said it, come
y digan,
on,
si él lo dijo,
if he said it,
si él lo dijo,
if he said it over my
si
life,
él lo dijo sobre mi vida,
if he said it over my children,
si él lo dijo sobre mis hijos,
if God dare say it over my family,
si él lo dijo sobre mi familia,
then it does not matter whatever devil, whatever demon, whatever hell I face, the word shall be fulfilled
entonces,
in my life.
Entonces no importa qué demonio o infierno yo venga en contra de mí, la palabra se tiene que cumplir en mi vida.
Once heaven releases a word,
cuando el cielo desata una palabra,
it can't take it back.
No lo puede tomar de regreso.
Did you hear what I just said?
¿Escucharon lo que acabo de decir?
Once heaven releases a word over your life,
cuando el cielo suelta una palabra sobre tu vida,
it can't take it back.
No lo puede tomar de regreso.
But watch this.
Pero miren esto.
Watch this, babe.
Miren esto.
If heaven releases a word over our lives,
si el cielo suelta una palabra sobre nuestras vidas,
and heaven can't take it back,
y el cielo no lo puede tomar de regreso,
what makes you think hell can even touch it?
¿Qué te hace pensar que el infierno puede tocarlo?
Here's a good Facebook status for you.
Este es un buen
un estado de Facebook para ti.
Status de Facebook.
Y'all ready?
¿Están listos?
Hell can't stop what heaven started.
El infierno no puede parar lo que el cielo comenzó.
Someone shout with me, hell can't stop.
Alguien grite conmigo, el infierno no puede parar
what heaven began.
Lo que el cielo comenzó.
Hell can't stop.
El infierno no puede parar.
What heaven started.
Lo que los cielos comenzaron.
That's why the warfare you go through.
Por eso la guerra en cual tú te encuentras.
The battle you go through.
La batalla que tú pasas.
It's not so that you can cry about it and have a little pity party about
it. No es para que tú estés llorando y tener una fiesta de llorar.
And say, God, where are you?
Y decir, Dios, ¿dónde estás?
And say, God, why me?
Y decir, Dios, ¿por qué yo?
Why do I gotta go through this?
¿Por qué tenía que pasar por esto?
Why do I gotta struggle?
¿Por qué yo tengo que batallar?
Why do I gotta fight?
¿Por qué yo tengo que pelear?
God, where are you?
Dios, ¿dónde estás?
And God's like, I'm in the same boat with you, but you just don't see me because you'd rather see your mountain rather than seeing me when you got all authority sleeping in the same boat with you, but you're faithless. You don't got the faith to see what's sitting in the same boat with you.
Y Dios dice, tú tienes la misma autoridad que yo tengo porque estamos en el mismo barco, pero tú no puedes ver porque estás muy ocupado diciendo tantas cosas, pero estamos en la misma autoridad porque estamos juntos.
Come on, pastora. Let's go. What you know about that?
I'm you.
She's what?
I'm you.
Oh.
We're one.
In case y'all didn't know, right? Pastor took authority over his wife a couple of months ago.
Oh my God.
And she's carrying baby number two, in case y'all didn't know. Come on.
Yes. Okay.
I had to say it because she keeps complaining. Bert, people are going to think I'm just gaining weight.
Sí. No quiero que la gente diga que estoy aumentando de peso.
Ooh, I lost my train of thought. What was I talking about?
That's what wives do.
Authority.
Autoridad.
In your home.
En tu casa.
Nah, let's not go there. All right. Jesus said.
Jesús dijo.
We're going to the other side.
Vayan al otro lado.
The storm arose.
La tormenta se levantó.
Against the word preached.
En contra de la palabra.
When Jesus gets up.
Y cuando Jesús se levanta.
He rebukes the storm.
Él reprende la tormenta.
And they get to the other side.
Llegan al otro lado.
And do you remember who was the man that met them at the shore?
¿Y se acuerdan quién fue el hombre que llegó al encuentro con ellos cuando
when
llegaron?
Jesus steps out of the boat,
cuando Jesús se sale del barco,
you're gonna like this, Roger.
Les van a gustar esto.
Jesus steps out of the boat,
Jesús se sale de del barco,
the Bible says,
y la Biblia dice
that a demon-possessed man
que un hombre con demonios
saw Jesus from afar,
vio a Jesús de lejos,
and came running over to Jesus's feet.
Y vino corriendo a los pies de Jesús.
And he says, "Why did you come to torment us?"
Y dijo, "¿Por qué viniste a atormentarnos?"
Now this is the crazy thing.
Y esta es la cosa loca.
Who told the demon that Jesus got there?
¿Quién le dijo a los demonios que Jesús había llegado?
Unless the demon heard something in the spiritual realm.
El demonio escuchó algo en el ámbito
espiritual. You're going to like this, all right?
Les van a gustar esto.
Because this is how I see the scripture.
Porque así es como yo miro la escritura.
I'm like, who in the world told this demon-possessed man that Jesus was coming to town?
Yo pienso, ¿quién le dijo a este hombre que Jesús iba a llegar a esta ciudad?
Unless the moment when Jesus steps out of the boat.
Al menos que el momento cuando Jesús sale de la barca.
I can imagine this.
Yo me puedo imaginar esto.
He steps out of the boat.
Él sale de la barca.
And in the spiritual realm.
Y en el ámbito espiritual.
You hear.
Él escucha.
Oh, y'all ain't getting it. Y'all ain't getting
it. No lo entendieron.
Jesus gets out of the boat and the demons hear.
Jesús sale de la barca y los demonios escuchan ese sonido.
And they said, hey.
Y dicen, oye,
what is that?
¿Qué fue eso?
We've heard that sound before.
Nosotros hemos escuchado ese sonido.
I wish y'all would get this, man.
Quisieran que entendieran esto.
They said, that's the sound of our master.
Y dijeron, ese es el sonido de nuestro dueño.
And they come out of the cave.
Y salieron de la cueva.
And they look.
Y ellos miran.
And they see the man that walks in authority.
Y vieron al hombre caminando en autoridad.
Getting out of the boat.
Saliendo de la barca.
Why did they come running to him?
¿Por qué llegaron corriendo hacia él?
Because in the heavenly.
Porque en lo celestial.
They came with the DNA.
Ellos vinieron con una ADN.
Of how to worship their king.
De cómo adorar su rey.
I wish y'all would get this, church.
Si quisieran que entendieran esto.
Y'all remember that a third of the angels of heaven were cast.
¿Se acuerdan que un tercio de los ángeles de los cielos fueron enviados con Satanás?
A third of the heavens was cast out of heaven.
Un tercio de los cielos fue enviado con
Satanás.
Because
when Satan was cast out,
porque cuando Satanás fue suelto,
a third of heaven went with him.
Un tercio de los cielos fue con él.
You want to know why?
¿Saben por qué?
Because rebellion never walks alone.
Porque la rebelión nunca camina sola.
We'll leave that one right there.
Vamos a dejar eso allí.
How do I know someone is in rebellion?
¿Cómo yo sé que alguien está en rebelión?
Because you try to take people with you.
Porque tú tratas de llevarte gente contigo.
If you feel like your season ended here,
si tú sientes que tu temporada terminó aquí,
but you're trying to take people with you,
pero quieres llevarte a gente contigo,
it ain't your season, baby.
No es tu temporada.
That's a demon.
Ese es un demonio.
That's a demon pulling you out.
Ese es un demonio sacándote.
All right, that was extra.
Okay, eso fue extra.
But a third of the demons went out of heaven.
Pero un tercio de los cielos salió con él.
And they knew how to worship the King of Kings.
Y ellos sabían cómo adorar al Rey de Reyes.
So isn't it crazy?
Entonces, ¿que no es un poco raro?
John, isn't this crazy?
¿Que no es un poco loco?
That a demon-possessed man.
Que un hombre lleno de demonios.
The Bible says no chains could hold him down.
La Biblia dice que ni cadenas lo pudieron aguantar.
They said that men would try to come and hold him down.
Decía que vinieron los hombres de tratar de aguantarlo.
And they couldn't hold him.
Y nadie lo podía aguantar.
Break the chains,
él rompía esas cadenas,
but he would stay in the cave.
Pero él se quedaba en esa cueva.
A demon possessed man,
un hombre poseído,
saw Jesus,
vio a Jesús,
came running,
vino corriendo,
bowed at his feet,
y se inclinó a sus pies,
and worshiped him.
Y empezó a adorar.
A demon possessed man,
un hombre poseído de demonios.
Isn't it crazy?
¿Que no es loco?
That most of us here ain't even possessed.
Que muchos de nosotros no estamos poseídos.
And you still don't know how to see Jesus come running and worship him.
Y tú no sabes cómo mirar a Jesús y venir a adorarle.
Your pastor's preaching tonight.
Tu pastor te está predicando en esta noche.
That's why when you don't worship,
por eso cuando tú no adoras,
I question.
Yo me pregunto,
because it's not a demon.
Porque no es un demonio.
If it were a demon, demons know how to worship.
Si fuera un demonio, los demonios aunque sea saben cómo inclinarse.
You're walking in rebellion.
Tú estás caminando en rebelión.
You don't have the recognition when the king walks in the
tú
room.
Tú no reconoces cuando un rey entra a un lugar.
You have discernment when a judge, if a judge were to walk in this room, all of y'all would stand up and shut your mouth and respect.
Si un juez entrara aquí, todos tendrían el discernimiento para pararse de pie y cerrar la boca con respeto.
But because the church lacks discernment.
Pero como la iglesia le falta el discernimiento,
we can't see when the king is in the room.
No podemos ver cuando el rey ha entrado a un lugar.
Because when the king walks in the room,
porque cuando un rey entra a un lugar,
all of us know how to bow down and worship.
Todos sabemos cómo inclinarnos.
Ooh,
y adorarlo. Siento el Espíritu Santo.
Believe in this hour.
Yo creo que en esta hora,
that the church is getting back their sensitivity to the presence of God.
Que la iglesia está recibiendo su sensibilidad a la presencia de Dios.
Where we all as a church know when the king is in the room.
Porque cuando todos podamos saber cuando un rey está en este lugar.
We worship.
Nosotros adoramos.
We praise him.
Nosotros alabamos.
He's been too good to me for me to be complaining about the stuff I'm going through.
Él ha sido tan bueno conmigo para yo estar renegando de cosas que están sucediendo.
God's been too good.
Dios ha sido tan bueno.
He's taken me out of too much.
Me ha sacado de tanto.
He's delivered me out of too much.
Me ha librado de tanto.
He's healed me, saved me, and delivered me.
Me ha sanado, librado y salvado.
So much so.
Tanto que.
That I can't keep quiet when the king is in the room.
Yo no puedo mantener en silencio cuando el rey está aquí.
I can't keep my mouth shut when the king is in the room.
Yo no puedo mantener mi boca cerrada cuando el rey está
aquí.
Can
we just worship the king for the next 30 seconds?
Podemos adorar al rey por los próximos 30 segundos.
Why don't you just jump up to your feet and give him praise?
Póngase de pie y dale alabanza.
Because the king is in the room.
Porque el rey está en este lugar.
Father, we worship you.
Padre, te adoramos.
Jesus, we thank you.
Jesús, te damos gracias.
Because you saved us.
Porque nos salvaste.
Delivered us.
Nos liberaste.
Set us free.
Nos liberaste. No rompiste cada cadena. Nos sacaste de la oscuridad.
Into your marvelous light.
Y trasladado en tu luz.
And that is what we're praising you for.
Y por eso te estamos adorando.
So we praise you.
Te adoramos.
We praise you.
Te adoramos.
Come on, lift up your voice. Just say we praise.
Vamos, levanta su voz y digan te adoro.
Come on, you don't need the music. Just shout. We praise you, Lord.
No necesitas música. Solamente di te adoro.
Come on, throw up your hands and lift up your voice.
Levanta sus manos y levanten su voz.
Come on, release a sound that the king is worthy of receiving.
Vamos, suelta un sonido que es digno para que lo reciba el rey.
Minister to the Lord.
Ministrale al Señor.
Minister to the King of Kings.
Ministrale al Rey de Reyes.
You're worthy, God.
Tú eres digno, Padre.
Let us hear the cry of a praying church.
Vamos a escuchar el sonido de una iglesia que ora.
Let us hear the sound of a church that knows how to seek the presence of God.
Vamos a escuchar el sonido de una iglesia que sabe cómo buscar la presencia de Dios.
You are worthy, God.
Tú eres digno, Padre.
You are worthy, God.
Tú eres digno.
You are worthy, God.
Tú eres digno.
You are worthy.
Tú eres digno.
There it is.
Ahí está.
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 Holy Spirit, move.
Espíritu Santo, muévete.
Holy Spirit, move.
Espíritu Santo, muévete.
If you're watching online, throw up those hands and just receive this moment.
Si tú estás viendo por línea, solamente levanta tus manos y recibe de este momento.
God, we are hungry for you, God.
Padre, tenemos hambre por ti.
We're thirsty for your presence.
Tenemos sed por tu presencia.
We want to seek your face.
Queremos buscar tu rostro.
We want to worship you, God.
Queremos adorarte.
There he is.
Ahí está.
There he is.
Ahí está él.
There he is.
Ahí está él.
The Holy Spirit is moving in this room.
El Espíritu Santo se está moviendo en este lugar.
I pray against every demonic attack against your mind right now.
Yo oro en contra de cada ataque demoníaco en contra de tu vida.
It lets you go now
te
in Jesus' name.
Te sueltan en el nombre de Jesús.
Depression, go now in Jesus' name.
Depresión, vete ahora en el nombre de Jesús.
We walk in authority tonight.
Caminamos en autoridad en esta noche.
We're praying with authority tonight.
Estamos orando con autoridad en esta noche.
Something is happening right there.
Algo está sucediendo ahí.
Come on, church. Something is happening.
Vamos,
right
iglesia.
There.
Algo está sucediendo.
Lift up your hands. Close your eyes. Something
levante
is happening
tus manos
right there.
Y cierra tus ojos porque algo está sucediendo.
Pray, 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 pray,
ora,
pray.
Ora, ora, ora.
Come on, pray, pray, pray,
vamos,
pray, pray.
Oren, oren.
Pray.
Vamos, oren.
Vamos, oren. Vamos, oren. Vamos, oren. Vamos, oren. Vamos, oren. Vamos, oren. Vamos, oren. Vamos, oren. Come on, remove the muzzle off of your mouth.
Vamos, quita eso de tu boca.
Loosen that tongue and begin to pray.
Suelta tu lengua y empieza a orar.
You're in the safest place right now.
Tú estás en el lugar más seguro ahora mismo.
To let heaven know you have a mouth.
Para dejarle los cielos saber que tú tienes una boca.
You're in the safest place.
Tú estás en el lugar más seguro.
The safest place is the presence of God.
El lugar más seguro es la presencia de Dios.
There it is. If the demons knew how to run to Jesus and bow down before him,
si los demonios sabían correr a Jesús e inclinarse delante de él,
can we just bow down before the Father tonight?
Podemos inclinarnos ante el Padre en esta
just
noche.
Find a spot. I don't know what God is doing right now, but just find a place and just bow before the King.
Yo no sé qué está haciendo Dios en este momento, pero inclínense y adoren al Rey.
Come on, let's get on our knees and
vamos.
Pray unto the King of Kings tonight.
Pongámonos en nuestras rodillas y adoremos
find
al Rey
a spot.
De Reyes.
You don't have to stay in your chair. Find
encuentra
a spot
un lugar.
Right here in the
encuentra un lugar.
If you're at home right now, if you're watching this online,
si tú estás en tu casa y viendo por línea,
find a spot there in
encuentra
your house.
Un lugar ahí en tu casa.
Bow down before the King of Kings.
Inclínense ante el Rey.
That authority is in the room.
Esa autoridad está en el cuarto.
That authority is in the room.
Esa autoridad está en este lugar.
If the demons know how to come before the Father,
si los demonios saben cómo venir ante el Padre,
and they know how to worship at His feet,
y saben cómo adorar ante sus pies,
how much more will this church,
cuánto más esta iglesia,
bow down before the Father,
se inclinará ante el Padre,
and recognize that He is the King of Kings,
y reconozcan que Él es el Rey de Reyes.
Everyone is bowing down.
Todos están inclinando.
Our cameramen are bowing down.
Nuestros hombres de la cámara se están inclinando.
Ushers are bowing down.
Los ujieres están inclinando.
The whole team is bowing down.
Todo el equipo se está inclinando.
Because when the King walks in the room,
porque cuando el Rey entra a un lugar,
we know how to worship Him.
Nosotros sabemos cómo adorar.
We know how to praise Him.
Nosotros sabemos cómo adorarlo.
deserve the glory, God.
Tú mereces la gloria.
You deserve the glory, Father.
Tú mereces la gloria, Padre.
I didn't know.
Yo no sabía
what you wanted to do tonight.
¿Qué es lo que tú querías hacer en esta noche?
But you brought us here.
Pero nos traíste aquí
to remind us.
Para recordarnos
that you are the person we're building this house around.
Que tú eres la persona en cual edificamos esta casa.
We're not building around a man.
No estamos edificando sobre un hombre.
We're not building around a gift.
No estamos edificando sobre un don.
We're building around your presence.
Estamos edificando sobre tu presencia.
We're building around the presence of God.
Estamos edificando sobre la presencia de Dios.
We came here tonight
y venimos en esta noche
to encounter God,
para encontrarnos con Dios,
His power,
con su poder,
His presence,
con su presencia,
and His authority.
Y su autoridad.
Can you just throw your hands up in the air?
Levanten sus manos
and just sing this out with us.
Y canten esto.
Come on, declare. There He is. Come on, church.
Vamos, iglesia.
Let's hear you sing, church. You are worthy of it all. Come on, all the voices in the room, declare. this out with me like this. Come on, every hand lifted all up. Come on, declare. All of the glory, all of the glory is yours, is yours. More time with every hand lifted high. You are worthy. You are worthy of it all.
Day and night, night and day.
Come on. You are worthy of it all.
Day and night, night and day.
For from me, from you are all things. And to you are all things. You deserve. Yes, Lord. Father, tonight,
en esta noche,
your presence is in this room.
Tu presencia está en este lugar.
And there's no other name,
y no hay otro nombre,
under heaven,
bajo los cielos,
in which demons have to bow,
en los cuales los demonios no puedan inclinarse.
Every knee has to bow,
toda rodilla se tiene que inclinar,
every tongue will confess,
y toda lengua confesará,
that Jesus Christ is Lord,
que Jesucristo es el Señor.
There is no other name,
no hay otro nombre,
there is no other name,
no hay otro nombre,
but the name of Jesus,
que el nombre de Jesús,
the name of Yeshua,
el nombre de Yeshua.
You are the King of Kings.
Tú eres el Rey de Reyes.
You are the Lord of Lords.
Tú eres el Señor de Señores.
There's freedom in your name.
Hay libertad en tu nombre.
There's healing in your name.
Hay sanidad en tu nombre.
There's deliverance in your name.
Hay liberación en tu nombre.
So I carry the authority of that name.
Yo cargo la autoridad de ese nombre.
And I worship.
nombre.
I praise with the name.
Yo adoro con ese nombre.
You are worthy, God.
Tú eres digno, Padre.
You are worthy, Father.
Tú eres digno, Padre.
His presence is in this place, y'all.
Su presencia está en este lugar.
And what God is doing tonight,
y lo que Dios está haciendo en esta noche,
is that he wanted to teach us,
es que nos quería enseñar.
It doesn't take hours.
No toma horas.
It takes hunger.
Toma hambre.
It doesn't take hours.
No toma horas.
It takes thirst.
Toma sed.
When you're thirsty, you drink.
Cuando tú tienes sed, tú tomas.
When you're hungry, you eat.
Cuando tú tienes hambre, tú comes.
The presence of God is wherever you go.
La presencia de Dios es donde tú vayas.
And what you are learning tonight,
y lo que estás aprendiendo en esta noche,
is this is not just a moment.
Es que esto solamente no es un momento.
But this is a movement in your home.
Este es un movimiento en tu casa.
Learning to take the presence of God from this room.
Aprendiendo de tomar de la presencia de Dios de este lugar.
Into your home.
En tu casa.
I feel the Spirit of God.
Siento el Espíritu del Señor.
I feel the Spirit of prophecy moving right now.
Siento el Espíritu de profecía moviéndose.
But I want you to know before I prophesy.
Pero quiero que sepas antes de que yo profetice.
That you're walking in a new authority tonight.
Que tú estás caminando en una autoridad nueva en esta noche.
Some of y'all right now.
Algunos en este momento.
You're beginning to feel almost as if heat is touching your hands.
Tú estás comenzando a sentir como si el calor está tocando tus manos.
Some of y'all might feel a heat right behind your back or your neck.
O a lo mejor sientes un calor detrás de tu espalda o tu
cuello.
Some of
y'all are beginning to feel heat in your feet.
Algunos están sintiendo calor en sus pies.
Because the Lord's saying you're about to walk in a new authority tonight.
Porque el Señor dice que estás a punto de caminar en una nueva autoridad en esta
noche.
You're
going to begin to walk as if you're undefeated.
Vas a empezar a caminar como si eres invencible.
You're going to walk like you know you're undefeated.
Vas a empezar a caminar como que tú sabes que eres invencible.
And what the Lord is doing tonight.
Y lo que el Señor está haciendo en esta noche.
Is that he's preparing you.
Es que te está preparando.
Not for where you are.
No para donde tú estás.
But for where you're going.
Pero hacia donde tú vas.
You came here tonight.
Tú viniste en esta noche.
So that God could launch you into a new season.
Para que Dios te pueda lanzar a una nueva temporada.
Because I feel like tonight.
Porque yo siento que en esta noche.
Is the announcement for someone.
Es el anuncio para alguien.
That is about to shift into a whole new realm.
Que está a punto de entrar a un nuevo ámbito.
Just stay right there. Just stay right there with the keys. Prepare the song, wonderful, glorious, matchless in every way. I feel that in my spirit. Hallelujah. Just give me a second right here. There's a young lady here tonight.
Hay una jovencita aquí en esta noche.
The Lord brought you here.
El Señor te trajo.
To announce your next season.
Para anunciar tu próxima temporada.
And I want you to bring your friend Janelle, I believe that's her name. I want you to bring her right here to the altar. I don't usually do this when I don't know people.
Normalmente no hago esto cuando no conozco a personas.
Because I don't know who Janelle is.
Porque yo no conozco a Janelle.
I met her right before service.
La conocí antes del servicio.
But tonight,
pero en esta noche,
is an announcement for her.
Es un anuncio para ella.
Because the Lord is announcing today.
Porque el Señor está anunciando hoy.
The ending of a cycle.
El final de un ciclo.
And the beginning of something new in your life.
Y el comienzo de algo nuevo en tu vida.
You even said in your heart.
Tú dijiste en tu corazón.
I want to be there tonight.
Yo quiero estar allí en esta noche.
Because the Lord was going to anoint you for your next season.
Porque el Señor te iba a ungir para tu próxima temporada.
And the Lord wants you to know you're not alone.
Y el Señor quiere que tú sepas que no estás sola.
You may be leaving the physical realm.
A lo mejor tú te vas de lo físico.
But the spiritual realm, you are guarded and you are protected.
Pero en lo espiritual tú estás guardada y protegida.
Just as these women came around you right now.
Así como estas mujeres te rodean.
There's 5 women altogether.
Hay 5 mujeres en total.
Because there's a new grace that's coming over your life tonight.
Porque hay una nueva gracia que viene sobre tu vida.
and you're walking into your grace.
Y estás caminando y entrando en tu gracia.
The Lord says, I'm never going to leave you nor forsake you.
El Señor te dice que nunca te dejará ni te desamparará.
But I wanted to bring you here tonight.
Pero quería traerte en esta noche.
To unlock the capacity for your next level.
Para desatar la capacidad para tu próximo nivel.
Because it's going to take a deeper intimacy with me.
Porque va a tomar una intimidad más profunda conmigo.
And I had to unlock a new language in you.
Y tenía que desatar un nuevo lenguaje en ti.
Because what you're going to begin to do is give birth to the new thing that's in you.
Porque lo que vas a comenzar a hacer es dar a luz a la cosa nueva que está dentro de ti.
So tonight,
pero en esta noche,
the Lord affirms and confirms.
El Señor afirma y confirma.
That your next shift.
Que tu próximo cambio.
You're not going alone.
No vas a ir sola.
But you will go like Moses.
Pero vas a ir como un Moisés.
I won't go unless your presence goes with
no
me.
No iré si tu presencia no va conmigo.
And that's been your prayer.
Y esa ha sido tu oración.
God, I don't want to go unless your presence goes
Señor,
with
yo
me.
No quiero ir si tu presencia no va conmigo.
So tonight.
Entonces en esta noche.
We stretch our hands over your life.
Estiramos nuestras manos sobre tu
and
vida.
And we declare.
Y declaramos
that what heaven started,
que lo que los cielos comenzaron,
hell is not going to be able to stop.
El infierno no podrá pararlo.
That what heaven began,
que lo que los cielos comenzaron,
hell will not stop.
El infierno no
so tonight,
pararlo.
Lift up your hands there, Janelle, where you are.
Levanta tus manos.
When I count to three, Father, I pray, Lord, tonight.
Padre, yo oro en esta noche.
By the power of your word.
Por el poder de tu palabra.
That your spirit come upon her.
Que tu espíritu venga sobre ella.
In the form of flames of fire.
En la forma de fuego.
Purify.
Purifica.
Renew.
Renueva.
Do a new thing.
Haz una cosa nueva.
Over her life.
Sobre su vida.
In Jesus name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Holy Spirit, you are invited.
Espíritu Santo, tú eres
we
invitado.
We invite you, Holy Spirit.
Espíritu Santo, te
come
invitamos.
Upon her now.
Ven sobre ella ahora. Una,
two,
dos,
three.
Tres.
Now, over her, over her, over her. Go, go, be filled, be filled.
Said Jenna,
be filled,
Jenna.
Be filled, be filled,
Jenna.
Be filled,
Jenna.
Be filled,
said
be
Jenna.
Filled. Come on, church, give him praise if you believe that he's in the room. Praise him, praise him.
Adóralo, adóralo.
Praise him,
adóralo.
Praise him,
adóralo.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Gracias, Espíritu Santo.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Gracias, Espíritu Santo.
The Lord is marking.
El Señor.
The Lord, as He started something in her tonight.
Así como él comenzó algo en ella en esta
He's
noche.
He's doing a new thing in many of you here tonight.
Él está haciendo cosas nuevas en muchos de ustedes aquí.
Because that wasn't a touch of a man.
Porque eso no fue toque de un hombre.
That was an empowerment of the Holy Spirit.
Ese fue un empoderamiento del Espíritu Santo.
I don't know what she needed from God.
Yo no sé lo que ella necesitaba de parte de Dios.
But whatever it was, she got it.
Pero lo que fue, ella lo recibió.
And just like her.
Y así como ella.
Many of you in this room.
Muchos de ustedes en este cuarto.
From the back to the front.
Desde de atrás hasta adelante.
Are receiving an impartation of the Holy Spirit.
Están recibiendo esa impartición del Espíritu Santo.
You have to know you walk in authority.
Tienes que saber que tú caminas en autoridad.
You have to know that you walk in power.
Tú tienes que saber que caminas en poder.
God's presence goes with you wherever you go.
Su presencia va contigo donde quiera que tú vayas.
Listen.
Escuchen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Gracias, Espíritu Santo.
I don't know who you guys are right here in the front row.
No sé quiénes son ustedes.
Are y'all guys together?
Están juntos.
Yeah. Remarried. Sorry, I was going to say brother, sister, husband, wife. Husband, wife. Not that y'all look alike, but y'all want to come up here? Just grab each other's
vengan
hands.
Hacia el frente.
Give me my ushers. Roger, come here with them. But just stand right here, guys. Because I don't. What is y'all's? What's your name, man? Justin and Celeste. Were y'all invited here, or y'all just came, or second time? Okay. Did y'all were invited by someone, or y'all just showed up? Y'all found us somehow. Instagram. I love Instagram. Come on, Instagram. Y'all speak English. Or Spanish and Spanish. Yeah, you could translate. It's fine. So everybody can get the word. The reason why God brought y'all here.
La razón de por cual Dios los trajo aquí.
Is because He's initiating a new process in you guys.
Es porque está iniciando un nuevo proceso en ustedes.
There's a deep hunger and a thirst for authenticity.
Hay una hambre profunda por lo auténtico.
And I believe that the Lord is doing a new thing in both of you guys.
Y yo creo que el Señor está haciendo algo nuevo en los dos.
He's forming you.
Él te está formando a ti.
To be the head of your household.
Para que tú seas la cabeza de tu casa.
So that you can lead.
Para que puedas guiar.
Into the new thing.
Hacia lo nuevo.
And I really see like God is unlocking men.
Y verdaderamente veo que Dios está abriendo
like
y desatando todos tus sentidos espirituales.
So much hunger inside of you for more.
Porque hay tanta hambre dentro de ti para más.
You know when God's in a room.
Tú sabes cuando Dios está en un
you
lugar.
Know when God's presence is there.
Tú sabes cuando la presencia de Dios está allí.
So much so that you can discern what's fake and what's not.
Tanto que tú puedes discernir cuando algo es verdadero y cuando no es.
To unlock, almost like you're going to begin to see differently from this day forward.
Pero el Señor va a empezar a desatar y vas a empezar a ver diferente.
God's voice is going to be so almost so sensitive.
La voz de Dios va a estar tan sensible a tu oído.
Like there's moments, man, when I'm preaching, I just hear God's voice right here.
Y hay momentos cuando yo estoy predicando cuando escucho la voz de Dios aquí.
And I actually remember you from last Sunday because the Lord highlighted you to me.
Y te recuerdo del domingo pasado porque el Señor te subrayó en mí.
When we're in a service, y'all.
Cuando estamos en un servicio.
The Lord begins to highlight people.
El Señor empieza como a marcar gente.
And I met up with John and Anna last week.
Y yo me junté con John y Anna la semana pasada.
And I said, Anna, there was this woman sitting right behind you.
Y le dije, Anna, había una mujer sentada detrás de ti.
The Lord kept highlighting me to her.
Y el Señor la estaba marcando.
Just like highlight, just like almost like this light shines on her.
Así como que si una luz está sobre ella.
And I said, I don't know who she was. And Anna was like, oh, that was my friend.
Y Anna me dijo, ah, fue mi amiga.
But she's moving, she's not coming back.
Pero ella se va a mudar, ya no va a regresar.
And that woman was Janelle.
Y esa mujer era Janelle.
And she's here.
Y ella está aquí.
And I said, man, I had a word for her.
Y le dije, ay, tenía una palabra para ella.
But the Lord brought her here tonight without even me knowing.
Y el Señor la trajo sin yo saber.
That I would have the opportunity to release that word over her
life. Que iba a tener la oportunidad de desatar esa palabra sobre su vida.
And I say that because last Sunday I remember you now.
Y digo eso porque el domingo pasado yo los recuerdo.
There's always moments when the Lord highlights people.
Hay momentos cuando el Señor marca personas.
And the reason why he does this.
Y la razón de por cual él hace eso.
Is to let you know that you're in the right place.
Es para dejarte saber que tú estás en el lugar correcto.
At the right time.
En el momento correcto.
With the right people.
Con la gente correcta.
How long have y'all been married?
¿Cuánto han estado casados?
2 years. Let's go, man. Let's
dos,
go.
Dos años.
Y'all, can y'all grab each other's hand right there, guys? I'm just going to pray over you guys because I just feel like I need to. Father, I thank you. Stretch out your hands towards me.
Estiren sus manos, por favor.
Father, I thank you, Lord, that tonight.
Padre, te doy gracias que en esta noche.
You're doing something in this moment.
Estás haciendo algo en este momento.
On this day.
En este día.
On this 18th of April.
Este 18 de abril.
You're their destiny.
Estás marcando sus destinos.
The ending of a cycle, the beginning of something new.
El final de un ciclo y el comienzo de algo nuevo.
Because the Lord is going to begin to shift you in the spirit.
Porque el Señor va a comenzar a moverte en el espíritu.
Jesus, John, come here, John. I feel like you need to release something over his life, and I just want you to like because we don't know each other. We don't know him, and he doesn't know us, and I feel like there has to be an affirmation in his life, in their both of their lives, more in him of what God has called them to do. So I just release what you feel in the spirit.
As you walked up, what I saw was I saw your family. Your family. Not her family. But your family in particular. And there's some things that you need to rise up above, because there's some things you see yourself even now that you don't even feel like you can stand and be like, this, can I be this, Lord? I don't know if I can be the dad or the father or the husband or this or that. You struggle a lot with an inner, something that's holding you back constantly, that's keeping you going from going forward. But God says, what he ministered to you tonight was the authority of Christ and what Christ has done for you as a man first. Then as a husband, then as a father. And God's gonna break and has broken generational curses, because you're the one that has stepped out further than those that are in your family. Because you took up the challenge to actually be who God wants you to be. The question is constantly going up in your mind, constantly going up in your mind. Isn't it a challenge for you to kind of hold you back? But don't be held back anymore. Tonight, that thing is broken off your life. next year, this time, you're going to be a totally different man. Your family is going to be totally changed and turned upside down. You're not going to recognize, she's not going to recognize who you are, because you're going to be just a totally different man. Hold your hands up right now, both of you. God's going to change your family. God's going to change this home totally. From the inside out, he's doing it. It's not a man that's going to do it. It's going to be by God's Spirit, and he's going to change your life. He's going to change you inside out. For this time next year, your family will not be the same. You're going to see promotions in your life. You're going to see things in your life that you want to acquire, to you think that you can never achieve, but God's going to open doors for you. He's going to show you that Jesus is the one that opens doors, and he's the one that closes doors. He's the one that raises up, and he's the one that brings down, because he's the one that has all the authority. So submit your heart, submit your life, both of you, to his kingdom and his word, and you'll see that next time, this year, mark it, that's why he said the date, because next year, this time, your lives will not be the same. It's going to be totally different. I believe you're going to walk it through, because the path that God has already paved for you has already been laid out. All you have to do is walk it out. So, Father, thank you, Lord God, in their life, Father, tonight, you've started something in your spirit. And, Father God, it's not going to be me that's going to end it. You're going to be the one that's going to bring it to fruition. You're the one that's going to bring the fruit of your word. Father, because you're the one that said, Father, when they come into your house, and the prophets begin to speak the word, you're the one that said, Father, they're the ones that are going to say, of a truth, God is here, and he's the one that has spoken. And my daughter, God is going to bless you. He's going to open doors for you, for businesses inside of you. He's going to begin open doors for you. He's going to give you the right connections that you need, the right wisdom, the right education that you need. Because you're very smart, you're very sharp, and God has those gifts on the inside of you. He's gonna stir you up tonight. You're gonna be the one that's gonna start attracting those things to you, because your faith is gonna reach out for them and bring them to you. Watch what I say. So Father, thank you, Lord God, for this home. Father, we pray your blessing over them tonight. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Come on, give him praise, y'all.
Vamos, adórenle.
Listen, y'all. You guys are not alone.
No están solos.
God brought you here because what's in you,
Dios los trajo porque lo que está dentro de ti,
was connected to what's in this house.
Está conectado a lo que está
and
en esta
what's
casa.
In this house,
y lo que está en esta
is
casa,
connected to what's in y'all.
Está conectado con lo que está dentro de
and
ustedes.
If God gives us the privilege,
y si Dios nos da el privilegio,
to walk together,
de caminar juntos,
we promise you that by this time next year,
te prometemos que para el próximo año,
there's just this renewing that God's going to do.
Va a haber un renovar que
and
Dios
it's going to be
hacer.
A beautiful thing, y'all.
Y va a ser
we
algo
bless
hermoso.
You guys.
Los bendecimos.
We bless you guys.
Los
come
bendecimos.
On, let's give it up for their lives. Thank you.
Vamos.
Come on, let's stand up to our feet.
Pongámonos de pie.
Let's just worship the King of Kings.
Vamos a adorar al Rey de Reyes.
Beautiful.
thank you, Lord.
Padre, te damos gracias.
That we can walk out of this room.
Que podemos salir de este lugar.
Knowing that you are with us.
Sabiendo que tú vas con
You've
nosotros.
Never left us.
Nunca nos has dejado.
Nor forsaken us.
Ni desamparado.
From this day forward.
Desde hoy en adelante.
We will walk in the authority.
Caminaremos en la autoridad.
That you have given us.
Que tú nos has dado.
To walk in freedom.
Para caminar en libertad.
In deliverance.
En la liberación.
Everywhere we go.
Donde quiera que vayamos.
Everywhere our hands lay.
Donde quiera que nuestras manos toquen.
The sick shall recover.
El enfermo será sano.
The blind shall see.
El ciego verá.
The mute will speak.
El mudo hablará.
The paralytic will rise.
El paralítico se levantará.
Because of the authority in this place.
Por la autoridad en este lugar.
Do you believe that tonight?
¿Lo crees en
Can
esta
y'all
noche?
Just put your hands together for Jesus.
Pongan sus manos juntas para
just give
Jesús.
Him praise for he is good.
Déale alabanza porque
He's
él
mighty.
Es bueno. Él es bueno, él es masombroso.
There's no one else like God. Listen,
no hay nadie como él. Escuchen.
Holy Spirit's in this room.
Espíritu Santo está en este lugar.
It's one of those moments where you don't get to preach everything you wanted.
Es uno de esos momentos donde tú no puedes predicar todo lo que tú puedes.
But I cannot neglect the fact that God literally just took over.
Pero no puedo negar que el hecho de que Dios solamente sobretomó el servicio.
And the house, the church that you get to be a part of.
Y la iglesia que tú puedes ser parte de.
Is one that it's sensitive to the move of the Holy Spirit.
Es uno que es sensible al movimiento del Espíritu Santo.
I didn't know that the Lord wanted to do this tonight.
Yo no sabía que el Señor quería hacer esto en esta noche.
But when I heard His voice,
pero cuando escuché su voz,
He says, "You're building this house around me or around you."
Él dijo, "Estás edificando esta casa alrededor de mí o alrededor de ti."
This is your house.
Y yo le dije, "Señor, esta es tu casa."
And He says, "Then watch what I'm going to do."
Entonces él me dijo, "Entonces mira lo que voy a hacer."
Was that powerful or not?
¿Fue poderoso o no?
I want you to take this with you.
Quiero que tomes esto contigo.
As you return to your homes.
Y regreses a tu casa.
Build an altar of God's presence.
Haz un altar de la presencia de Dios.
Get your family.
Agarra tu familia.
As we lead into the next few weeks.
Porque mientras lleguemos a las próximas semanas.
We're going to build undefeated families.
Vamos a edificar familias invencibles.
Someone shout, "We are undefeated."
Alguien grite, "Soy invencible."
Someone shout, "We are undefeated."
Alguien grite, "Soy invencible."
Look at your neighbor, tell them, "We're undefeated."
Dile a tu vecino, "Soy invencible."
Look at your other neighbor, tell them, "We're undefeated."
Dile a tu otro vecino, "Somos invencibles."
Now, can we just shout like we're undefeated tonight?
Podemos gritar
Come
como
on,
si
can
somos
we just
invencibles.
Praise them like we're undefeated. There's no one like him.
No hay
like
nadie
there's
como
no other
él.
God beside him.
No hay nadie como él.
Like every demon bows and every tongue will confess.
Todo demonio se
inclinará. That Jesus Christ is Lord.
Toda lengua confesará
no one like
que Jesús
him. There's no one
es
beside
rey.
Him. Oh.
And in this moment, Father,
y en este momento, Padre,
we just want to bless your people.
Queremos bendecir a tu pueblo.
And we declare this moment, Lord,
y declaramos en este momento,
that this is going to be a week full of your presence,
que va a ser una semana llena de tu presencia,
full of your power,
llena de tu poder,
full of encounters with you, Lord,
llena de encuentros contigo, Señor,
so your name be glorified,
para que tu nombre sea glorificado.
We honor you today.
Te honramos hoy, Señor.
And thank you.
Y gracias.
Because we serve a God
porque servimos a un
that
Dios
is undefeated.
Que ha sido, no